And welcome back. This is the RPG Chick. We have recently rescued Liara from the Prothean ruins and the Geth and all kinds of good stuff. We went around and talked to our crew some more, and she's joining us as part of our crew, Liara. So,
good timing, Commander. We got a transmission coming in from the Citadel.
All right.
Priority clearance.
Good timing. Yeah, from who? I'd like to know from who at once. By the way, we have two more clusters to explore two more solar systems to explore in this cluster. Sorry about that. And so we're going to be doing that next, but let's see, of course, who this is, because we have no other choice to do anything but that. And from who?
Is it the ambassador?
It's not his signature. I think it's from the council. I'll patch it through to the comm room.
Oh, so we're going to meet this... Okay, we're going to the comm room. The hell is this unwarranted intrusion? And my little thing went away. Okay.
Commander Shepard, we've received information that may be critical to your mission against Saren.
I was just thinking, good! good.
I'll take all the help I can get.
We've received an urgent message from one of our infiltration regiments in the Traverse.
Infiltration units?
You mean spies.
Spectres tend to attract attention, Commander. But they are only one arm of the Council. Special task groups are often a better option for monitoring developing situations.
We currently have several infiltration units scattered throughout the border regions of Citadel space. This particular unit was gathering intel on Saren.
And?
What did they find?
Unfortunately, the message we received was little more than static. The infiltration team must be in a situation where they can't set up proper interstellar communications. But the message was sent on a channel reserved for mission-critical communications. Whatever they were trying to tell us, we know it was important. Considering your interest in Saren, we thought you might want to investigate this. Find out what happened to our team. The signal originated from the planet Vermeier.
Vermeier? Where's that? Thanks for the info.
I'll look into it.
The Council prefers not to become involved in the specifics of Spectre activities. We only want you to be aware of all your options, including Vermeier. Good luck, Commander Shepard. We will keep you advised if we learn anything else.
Paragon plus two, Codex.
Pharos is a habitable world in the Attican
Vermeier.
Beta Cluster. Vermeier is a lush world located on the frontier of the Attican Traverse. Its vast seas and orbital position on the inner life zone have created a wide equatorial band of humid, tropical terrain. Only the political instability of the region has impeded efforts at colonization. Many times the Citadel has opened negotiations to settle Vermeier with various criminal gangs and petty dictatorships in the nearby terminus systems. All fell apart due to internal power shifts within the opposing parties. The Citadel has written off the colonization of Vermeier as impossible without significant political change. The Terminus powers themselves are unlikely to ever settle Vermeier. Most lack the resources to support settlement of a virgin world, finding it more expedient to steal from their neighbors than build for themselves.
Tsk, tsk. Council races. Solarian Special Task Group. Okay. Solarian intelligence field agents are grouped into an organization called the Special Tasks Group. STG operators work in independent cells performing dangerous missions such as counterterrorism, infiltration reconnaissance, assassination, and sabotage. The STG is a proactive organization, puncturing worrisome trends before they become movements. At any time, a dozen groups are operating covertly within the lawless terminus systems, sowing dissent among the various factions. Civilian analysts also note how troublesome hinge point individuals in terminus frequently meet unexpected deaths. STG operators are feared throughout the galaxy for their clear-eyed, remorseless practicality. They are willing to do whatever it takes to achieve their mission, even if it kills civilians or results in the team's own destruction. In many ways, they are akin to the Council Spectres. Recently, a number of STG cells have been redeployed from Solarian Union. It is assumed they are in the Terminus and Attican Traverse, investigating reports of Geth activity beyond the Perseus Vale. Indeed. Okay. Well, I got an itch. Okay. Alright, we're just going to finish with this cluster first. Since we're already here. Leaving Therum. Leaving Knossos system. Sparta, we did. Let's go to Athens. Salamis! Okay. I'd like to start with the outermost planet, Pharos. Distant Pharos has seen only a cursory examination by an unmanned probe. It has a trace atmosphere of nitrogen and argon. Its surface is mainly composed of tin with deposits of carbon. Deeper craters have been partly filled by ice, suggesting there may be a significant amount of water locked up beneath its frozen surface. A large ice-bright crater in the southern hemisphere makes the planet visible from the inner system, leading to the planet's name. The crater gives it the name of Pharos? I don't get the reference there. It takes 275 years, Earth years, for it to orbit the sun completely. That's crazy. Turian insignia recovered. Scans of the planet Pharos revealed an abandoned base on its moon. The recon team found nothing of interest, but much of the debris was marked with the Magna Colony insignia. This is the second from... second last one. Circe is a modestly sized hydrogen-helium gas giant with traces of sulfur and chlorine. These give it its striking yellow-green tint. As the development of the Proteus colony continues, Circe will likely be developed for helium-3 mining. While scanning this gas giant, you detected a large concentration of helium-3. Cool. Third last, Nausicaa. I think I've heard of this system. Sounds very familiar, these names. Traces of sodium in the atmosphere give Nausicaa its overall dark gray color, but is otherwise a typical hydrogen-helium gas giant. An abundance of water vapor in the upper atmosphere account for its white clouds. Proteus. Like the Hadar homeworld, Proteus has more than 90% oceanic cover. The incredible heat thrown off from Athens raises global humidity to 100%, creates constant cloud cover, and powers colossal typhoons that rage across the surface year-round. Hot, humid, and storm-racked, Proteus's rare combination of oxygen, nitrogen atmosphere, and carbon-based biosphere nevertheless recommended for colonization. A pilot program is studying the possibility of colonies below the ocean surface, safe from the worst effects of the weather. Well, there's already a colony founded in 2179. When you're talking about their thinking of the possibility of colonies. Population is already 12,470, capital of Ithaca. Proteus has a large amount of free oxygen. Doesn't cost a thing. And finally, Salamis. The geological properties of Salamis have been scanned from orbit, but little else is known about it. Due to its thick carbon dioxide atmosphere and proximity to the energetic star Athens, the equatorial daytime temperatures have been known to turn the surface molten. The crust is composed of iron with deposits of platinum group metals. Okay. We're done with this system. Now to Macedon. Last one. Fargalus? Fargalus is a standard hydrogen-helium gas giant with an abundance of airborne hydrocarbons. Wow, this is the shortest description yet. Scans from orbit have detected a large concentration of xenon. Padovig? What's these names? Padovig is the second of the Macedon system's terrestrial planets, and by far the most interesting. Most of the surface is covered by a vast sea of liquid ammonia, in which a unique aquatic ammonia-based biosphere has evolved. Or developed, rather. While the frozen continents are largely bereft of life, a rich bounty of complex organisms, many larger than a human, flourish in the chilly, toxic seas. While dreadfully inhospitable to humans, Padovig is suitable for colonization by the Volus. Negotiations between the System's Alliance and the Volus's patrons, the Turian hierarchy, have made good progress. Damn. I want to live here. You know how cold that is? So there's four planets here. Porolan is an enormous terrestrial planet, half again the size of Earth. Despite its thick atmosphere, the weak output of the red dwarf Macedon leaves its surface biting cold. The crust is mainly composed of silica, but significant deposits of iron and other industrial metals are present. These iodes may prove which are lodes. Sure, if this is a... I guess loads, it's an L. May prove rich enough to be profitably mined despite the heavy gravity. Matriarch's writings recovered. You were scanning the planet Porolan when a strange signal came from orbit. Navigator Presley determined the signal was from an ancient beacon. Your salvage team brought the beacon aboard and found one of Matriarch Dilanaga's writings in its storage compartment. Awesome. And finally, Sharjila. We can land on this one. Level 1 pressure hazard. Sharjila has a very dense atmosphere of ammonia and oxygen. Its temperate surface is mainly composed of alumina with deposits of sulfur. Comm buoys in the system have recently logged a number of unregistered vessels operating nearby. Sharjila has an extensive silicon-based oxygen-breathing ecology. Heavily populated areas are covered with fine silica, silicon dioxide, dust, the repository byproduct of the world's higher animal forms. High-speed surface winds, often laden with abrasive silica dust, present a hazard. In areas where the wind deposits a great deal of silica, footing can be treacherous. EVAs are discouraged. Huh. So watch out for that silica and wind. Atmospheric pressure. 39 Earth atmospheres. Okay, so... not completely sure if this is gravity. Oh, gravity is the point. Basically the same as Earth. Okay. So it's just the atmospheric pressure that's pretty bad. Is the Mako up to the task here? Oh, I think they are. Hold on a second. She has biotic strength. She doesn't have the tech that we need. I don't know. I think, at least for now, I'm going to stick with Rex and Tally. It's a good mix of all our, you know, skills put together. Sorry, Liara. I don't know if we were told anything about this place. I don't think so. Debris here, stronghold here, and an anomaly here. Okay. We got that up there. Once we get out of this place, out of this, out of the Mako, we immediately start taking damage. Oh my. How steep is this here? On the other side of all this crap. Oh, this. Crash probe. I'm gonna save. Not you. This. Rather tough. No. Yeah. Omnigel. Ooh, medical interface 5. Incendiary explosive 5. Let's get back in here. Here we go. So what's the difference? Cool. Good resistance to toxin now. Talia has 4, so I'm gonna upgrade her to my... she has 3, I'm gonna upgrade her to my 4. And oh, wasn't it like grenade or something? I think it was high explosive, wasn't it? Incendiary, high, cryo, okay. Alright, so now we'll head to the stronghold. Whoops, whoops, whoops. Well, it's on the other side of that. Not sure which way I should go around. I'll go this way. It just looks more promising. Because I don't want to try to go up that. These foothills, yeah. Well, this is really the long way around. Oh my god. Whee! I went completely out of my way, didn't I? Oh boy. Don't be putting your fire laser sights on me. Can I get closer? Go around this way, maybe? Oh crap. Oh, those are our shields going down there. I have to get closer. There's just no other way. I can just run them over. Oh, they're people. I didn't realize those were people. Repairing.
Oh, compromised.
Repairing, repairing. Should I repair again? Not time yet. There's only a couple more. Got him, huh? Under fire. No, we're fine. At least right now. She scares me when she does that. Oh. There's a lot of baddies here. What are these things?
Let's get moving.
Uh-huh. Let's get moving.
Go, go, go!
This looks like identical to the other place. I did not see you there. You don't go it. You're the only one left. I know he's right there. Whew. Good. That was a pretty hairy battle. Pretty hairy. Upgrade kit. Yay! Incendiary rounds and shredder rounds for. A shotgun. Heavy armor for Rex. More ammo upgrade. Weapon upgrade. Okay. Excuse me. Shields are much better, but damage protection is not. I think I'll just hold on to it as an option. Probably won't use it, but you never know. Kinetic stabilizers. Get rid of some of these. Phasic rounds. Yeah. And I'm not upgrading much or anything yet, actually. Combat scanner. Mercenary rounds 5. And finally, he's got the heatsink 2 and incendiary rounds 4. Okay. Oh, we can upgrade. I missed that somewhere. Let's see. Tactical armor, okay. Right, I can get to medium now. You may now equip medium armor.
Yay!
An advanced shield boost. Restores 40 of your shield per second. Okay, that's our points this time. Rex. Let's give him armor. Tally. Decryption, one more. And armor. So medium armor for human. Oh my god, that stinks so bad compared to what I have. 14, 63, 10. That's... Man, that stinks. Okay, I'm still wearing light for now. Gonna have to find some good medium armor. Fuel tank. So what are these guys doing out here, huh? Something illegal? The map for this place. Yeah, it's pretty much... This is dead on. as the base on the other world.